Good day, everyone. So today we will be discussing about a prism. So first, a three-dimensional figures occur everywhere in the world around us, especially in fields such as architecture. So as we can see, if we visit in the city, we can see tall buildings. So in that, we can conclude that a building is just an example of a rectangular prism. So first, we will define the word prism. So when you say a prism, it is a three-dimensional figure that has two parallel congruent bases connected by lateral faces. So today, we will not be focusing only on prism, but also the parts of a prism. So first, when you see lateral faces, face or faces, it is a lateral face of a prism are always parallelograms and are usually rectangles. So a prism is named by its base shape. So as we can see, I have here a three-dimensional figure, an example of a three-dimensional figure. So as we can see, it is a rectangular prism. Since a prism is named by its base, so the base here can be found in the top and in the bottom of this figure. So as you can see, it is a rectangle, so we can name this prism as rectangular prism. So on this figure, there are many parts we can find. So first, as what I've said, it's base. So the base can be found on the top and on the bottom of a prism. So the second one is the height. We can also find the height of a prism. But we will now focus on the lateral face. So on this prism, we can find the lateral face of this one is this side, this front side, and also on this side. And also, we can find a lateral edge or edges of a prism, but we will discuss it more on later on. So, my main goal here is just to show you what where and where can we find the lateral face of a prism. So, for example, also in a cube one, but I don't have a figure of a cube one. But we can see the cube is just it has a four same sides. So we can see the lateral faces of a cube on the both sides of the prism. So the base and the lateral faces of a cube will be equal. So later on we will discuss the lateral edges of a prism.
Good day, everyone. Now we're gonna talk about the lateral edges of the prism. What is the lateral edges of the prism? These are the line segments that connect the corresponding vertices of the bases of the prism. The lateral edges of the prism are parallel and congruent. Sometimes, the lateral edges of the prism and the altitude are the same. That's we called a right prism because the lateral edge makes a right angle with the base. There are different types of prism. The pentagonal prism, rectangular prism, triangular prism, and hexagonal prism. The pentagonal prism is a prism having two pentagonal bases and five rectangular sides. The rectangular prism, it is a cuboid that is a hexahedron, a six-faced solid. Its faces are quadrilaterals. Cuboid means like a cube in the sense that by adjusting the length of the edges or the angles between edges and faces, a cuboid can be transformed into a cube. A triangular prism, it is a polyhedron that made up of two triangular bases and three rectangular sides. It is a three-dimensional shape that has three side faces and two base faces that connected to each other through the edges. And the last one, which is the hexagonal prism, it is a prism composed of two hexagonal bases and six rectangular sides. So in these four types of prism, let's just focus on their lateral edges. So in pentagonal prism, there are 15 edges. In rectangular prism, there are 12 edges. Triangular prism, there are 9 edges. And in hexagonal prism, there are 18 edges.
All right, let's move on to right and oblique prism. Let us know what is the difference between the two. Okay, oblique prism is one that seems to tilt at an angle. When we say oblique prism, the congruent bases will not appear directly above one another when the prism is sitting on its base. Okay, the line segments joining the corresponding endpoints of each base are still congruent and are still parallel to one another. So they are still congruent and parallel. However, they are not perpendicular to the bases and do not represent the height of the prism. Okay, the oblique prism are not perpendicular to the bases and they do not represent the height of the prism compared to the right prism. Okay, the height of an oblique prism does not lie on, nor is it parallel to a lateral edge. The lateral faces in an oblique prism are parallelograms. Okay, the lateral faces in an oblique prism are parallelograms. Cross sections parallel to the bases in each prism, right or oblique, will be congruent to the bases. Okay. The height of a prism is the distance between the two bases. In a right prism, the height is lateral edge. Okay, in the right prism. In the case of the oblique prism naman, the height is the shortest line segment. Okay, the height is the shortest line segment between the extended bases as shown. Okay, let us see the example here. Okay, that is the example of oblique prism. Okay. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. I will be reporting about right prism. So, what is right prism? So, accordingly, right prism is the congruent bases will appear directly above one another when the prism is sitting on its base. The second definition says that parallel segments are referred to as lateral edges and represents the height of the prism. The last definition is the line segments joining the corresponding endpoints of each base are congruent, are parallel to one another, and are perpendicular to the bases. So I will be providing examples so that you will know how to determine a right prism. So, the next slide, you will see a right rectangular
prism. So according to the definition, the bases should be congruent because it says that the congruent bases will appear directly above one another. So if the base is rectangular, so in this figure, it is a right rectangular prism. So of course the base is rectangle. So this is the base, and it should be congruent above. They should be the same, congruent, or equal. The next definition says that the parallel segments are referred to as lateral edges. So for the information of everyone, these are the lateral edges and represents the height of the prism. So the lateral faces in a right prism are rectangles. So the lateral faces in this right rectangular prism are this one. The lateral faces in a right prism are rectangles. So it should be rectangles. So these are rectangles. So the next slide is these are the examples of right prism. The right pentagonal prism, right triangular prism, and right rectangular prism. So how to determine if those are right prisms? So in this, in your screen, you can see sentences. First is, the congruent bases will appear directly above one another when the prism is sitting on its base. So, I've mentioned it earlier. The next thing is, are parallel to one another and are perpendicular to the bases. The next thing is, the lateral faces in a right prism are rectangles. So, let's go back to the examples. Let's take a look at the first example, which is the right pentagonal prism. So the shaded parts are the bases. So it is a right prism, specifically a right pentagonal prism, because the bases are congruent to one another. Second is, lateral faces in a right prism are rectangles. So in right pentagonal prism, the lateral should be lateral faces should be rectangles. So, as you can see, it forms rectangle. So that is the lateral faces, and these are the height or the lateral edges. So let's proceed to the next example, which is the right triangular prism. So it is so first is the base is congruent. The bases is congruent to one another and are parallel to one another or perpendicular to the base. The second example is a right triangular prism rather. So it is a right prism because the bases are congruent to one another and the line segments joining the corresponding endpoints of each bases are congruent, are parallel to one another, and are perpendicular to the base. They are parallel to one another, they are congruent, and are perpendicular to the base. Next example is the right rectangular prism. So the shaded parts are the bases. The bases again are congruent to one another. The segments joining The line segments joining the corresponding endpoints of each bases are congruent, are parallel, and are perpendicular to the bases. And also, the lateral faces are rectangles. So it is a right prism, specifically a right rectangular prism. Sorry. So that would be all for my report. Hope you understand and you gain knowledge about right prism. Thank you so much for listening.
In this time, we are going to discuss the altitudes of triangular prism. The altitude of a triangle is a perpendicular that is drawn from the vertex of a triangle to the opposite side. Since there are three sides in a triangle, three altitudes can be drawn in it. Altitude po, it is a straight line. A straight line that the vertex and going to the opposite side. Sa altitude po, we are creating a line segment. And it is the measurement of its angle is equal to 90 degree. Different triangles have different kinds of altitudes. Like for scalene in isosceles, in acute triangle and in obtuse triangle has different kind of altitudes, or ang position po ng altitudes nito. The altitude of a triangle, which is also called its height, is used in calculating the area of a triangle and is denoted by the letter H. In finding the measurement of an altitude, we are using the formula of height. I-discuss lang natin yan mamaya ang on how to solve for measurement of an height or for the altitude. Okay, next. A triangle can have three altitudes. The altitudes can be inside or outside the triangle, depending on the type of a triangle. What I have said earlier, that different triangle has different altitudes. Nakadepende po ito sa measurement of the triangle. The altitude makes an angle of 90 degree to the side opposite to it. The point of intersection of the three altitudes of a triangle is called the orthocenter of the triangle. Ang orthocenter po ay yung kung saan ang when we are making an three altitudes within one triangle, yung kung saan nagmi-meet yung altitudes or the point, the intersection of the point of the altitudes, ay yun po ang tinatawag na orthocenter. An altitude of a triangle is perpendicular segment that joins a vertex of the triangle to the opposite sides. In every angle, we can create an altitude going its opposite sides. And in the segment, in this, the segment of an altitude, it can be a bisector of the opposite side. For example, in the figure number 3, the triangle ABC, in a segment AB, the endpoint of segment CZ, which is Z, is the bisector of segment AB. Okay, it is an obtuse triangle. We know that obtuse triangle has more than 90 degree of its angle. In this triangle, ang altitude po niya ay nasa labas. The altitude is not only inside. It can be outside or inside depends the triangle, kung anong klase na triangle. In obtuse, because it is more than 90 degree angle, ang altitude po niya ay nasa labas. The segment YZ will be extend and the angle X or the vertex of X will be make a straight line going downward to touch down the extended segment to create an altitude and has a 90 degree angle. And it is the given formula of the altitude of a triangle. The basic formula to find the area of a triangle is area equals 1/2 times base times height, where the height represents the altitude. Altitude is the height of the triangle. Using the formula, we can derive the formula to calculate the height of a triangle, which is alt equals 2 times area divided by base. We have an example using this formula. In this problem, the three sides are given, so that we have to find the height. Okay. In side A, equals 9. In B, 10. In C, 11. Using this formula, the formula for finding the height, first, we are going to solve for area. First, we are going to find the area to solve its height. Area is equal to S times S minus A times S minus B and S times S minus C. Ito pong S is stands for semi-perimeter. Para po makuha natin yung area, first, we need to solve for the semi-perimeter of the triangle. Ito po ang formula ng semi-perimeter, S is equal to A plus B plus C and divided by 2. Ang A po natin ay 9, then 10, and 11 ang C. Then divided by 2, 9 plus 10 plus 11 is equal to 30. Divided by 2 equals 15. Ang semi-perimeter po natin ay 15. And next ay dito naman tayo sa area. Ang S po natin ay 15. Then S minus A, 15 minus 9. Then ang S minus B, 15 minus 10. And S minus C will be 15 minus 11. And then, next po ay i-minus natin yung S, which is the 15. 15 minus 9 equals 6. 15 minus 10 equals 5. Then, 15 minus 11 equals 4. In the next step, we are going to use the prime factorization, which is maghahanap po tayo ng the smallest number, the integers or the given number. Sa 15 po, kung magagamit natin ito ay ang 5 times 3. And in 6 will be 3 times 2. And ang 5 and 4 bring down na natin yan. And then next, i-multiply natin ang kapareho na number, which is the 5, the same sila, 5 times 5 equals 25. Then, 3 times 3 equals 9. And then, ang naiwan ay ang 4 and 2 ay i-bring down na rin natin. And after, we are going to put the square root in each number. The square root of 25 is 5, then sa 9 ay 3, then sa 4 2, then square root of 2 bring down na rin natin, so that after we are going to multiply. 5 times 3, 5 times 2 equals 30. Then, square root of 2. And it is the final area of a triangle, given triangle. And we are going to use our scientific calculator to solve the 30 to the square root of 2, which is area approximately equal to 42.4. And then, nakuha na natin yung area natin. To find the height, we are using this formula. A is equal to 1/2 times base times height. Ang area po natin ay 30 to the square root of 2 equals 1/2 times, ang base po natin ay 10 at times h. 1/2 times 10 is equal to 5. We are going to divide this 5 to the both side. 30 and the square root of 2 divided by 5 is equal to 6 to the square root of 2. Then, ang sa kabila naman ay cancel natin, kaya h lang ang na iwan. And then, using the scientific calculator to simplify the 6 to the square root of 2, and it is the result 8.48, or h approximately equal to 8.48, and it is the result for our height.
Good day, everyone. Today, I will report the surface area of triangular prism. So, it has the form. It has a formula on how to get the whole surface area of a triangular prism. So, which is SA stands for surface area equals 2 times base, 2 times base, because it has 2 bases, the front and back, then rectangles, the 3 rectangles, which is the bottom, right, and left. So, as you can see the example, so here, triangular prism, so it has 7 inches, 6 inches, and 5 inches. So it has a given, no? So, of course, the height is 4 inches. So, look at the right. So, if you imagine, no, na pag i-fold na to na, so, ma-form na siya, og, like yun, na sa akong, sa left side, triangular prism. So, how to get the whole surface of triangular prism? So, balik ta sa formula. So, SA equals 2 base plus rectangle plus rectangle plus rectangle. So, first na to kwaon is ang 2 base, 2 times base, because it has 2 bases ang form ang triangular prism, which is the back and front. So, the formula on how to get the 2 base is area is equal to 1/2 times base times height. So, base given of triangular prism, so the base here is 6 inches, no? 6 ang base. Then ang height is 4 inches. So, 6 times 4 equals 24. So, the 1/2 of 24 is 12. So, the area of 2 bases is equal 12 squared inches. Okay, next, rectangle. The first rectangle. So, the bottom. No? The bottom. So, the formula on how to get the bottom is length times width. So, the length here, no, the longest line is 7 inches. Then the width is 6 inches. So length times width, or 7 times 6, equals 42. 42 squared inches. So that is the area of the bottom, the bottom face. So next, the third, the second rectangle, which is the right face, no, the right face, second one. So again, the formula on how to get the area is length times width. So the length is 7 inches. So the right right face man, so kini nasa ibabaw no kan ay 5 inches ang right, then katong sa picas niya katong 5 inches mao na siya ang left. So 5 inches, 7 times 5 equals 35. 35 squared inches. So last rectangle is ang left. So dili naman na siya, pwede po nato i-solve, pwede na po dili, no? Kay same raman sila og measurement sa kuan, right ug left, no? Ang right ug left same ra na siya og measurement. So 35 pod. Okay. So balik tas ato ang formula. So nakuha naman nato ang unsa ni ang value, no, sa duha ka bases, sa bottom, sa right and left. So balik sa formula. So, surface area or SA equals 2 times base plus 4 plus rectangle plus rectangle plus rectangle. So the value of 2 base, 2 times base equals 12, no? So copy lang nato 2 times 12. So substitute bilang value 12. So first rectangle sa bottom is 42. So plus 42. Next sa right 35 plus 35, then sa left plus 35. Then we add first it multiply sa nato. 12 times 2 equals 24. Copy plus 42, 35 plus 35, ang value na sa left and right is 70. So 24 plus 42 is equal to 66. No, 66 plus 70 is equal to 136 squared inches. So that is the value of whole surface area in triangular prism. No, mona siya ang value sa tanan, no, nga sa duha ka base, back and front, right and left, and bottom. So that would be all. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I am Monica Apostol, and together with Mikey Bugag, we will discuss about the lateral area and the surface area of a right prism. So a lateral area is the sum of the areas of all the lateral faces. So we must remember that a lateral face is any face that is not a base. Well, the surface area is the amount of space covering the outside of a three-dimensional figure. So our focus for today is to find the lateral area and the surface area of a right rectangular prism and a right triangular prism. First, let's find the lateral area and the surface area of a rectangular prism. To find the lateral area, the formula is P times H. P stands for perimeter and H for height. Well, the formula of a surface area is 2B plus PH. B stands for the base and PH is the formula of a lateral area. For example, I have here a rectangular prism with a length of 12 meters, its width is 6 meters, and its height is 7 meters. So, we must find the lateral area and the surface area. To find the lateral area, the formula is perimeter times its height. So, the rectangular prism perimeter formula is the sum of its two length plus its two width. So the new derived formula is two length plus two width times its height. So since the length, width, and height are already given, let's substitute it. So we have, for its two length, we have 2 times 12. For its two width, we have 2 times 6 times its height, which is 7. So first, let's multiply first the numbers inside the parentheses. So we have 2 times 12 is equal to 24 plus 2 times 6, which is 12, times the height, which is 7. So 24 plus 12 is equal to 36 times 7 is equal to 252. So since it is a lateral area. A lateral area is an area, so we must square the unit that is used. So the unit used is meter. So thus, the lateral area is 252 square meter. So the next one, let's find the surface area. The formula is 2b plus ph. So to find the base, the formula to use is land times width, and the ph is the formula of the lateral area. So our new derived formula is 2 times the land times width plus the lateral area. So since the land and the width are already given, and we also have the measure of the lateral area, let's substitute it. So we have 2 times the length, which is 12, times its width, which is 6, plus the lateral area, which is 252. So let's multiply first the numbers inside the parentheses. We have 12 times 6 is equal to 72. Then 2 times 72 is equal to 144 plus 252. The result is 396. So since it is a surface area, so we must square the unit. So the surface area of this rectangular is 396 square meter.
Hello everyone, my name is Mikey Obugag. My portion is about lateral and surface area of a right prism. Since it is already discussed by my co-classmates about lateral and also the surface area of a prism, my portion is to give an example and how to find the lateral and the surface area of a right prism. For my discussion today, I will be focusing on the triangle prism. How to find the lateral and surface area of a triangle prism. As you can see here, in our illustration, we have the triangular prism. There are the components of a triangle prism. We can distinguish the length area and also the height by L sub 1 and also L sub 2. Same manner of the height sub 1, height 1 and the height 2. As you can see here in the triangle, it differentiate by L sub 1 and also sayang next partner mo ang L sub 2. The measure of our L sub 1 is 12.2 centimeter. And also sa itong L sub 2 is 4.7 centimeter. And our L sub 1 is 2 centimeter. And our L sub 2, which is height, is 20 centimeter. And our base, just like this, the below of the triangle, is 7.9 centimeter. Now, let us find lateral area. What is the formula in finding the lateral area? To find the lateral area, we have the formula of LA is equal to PH. Lateral area is equal to L sub 1 plus L sub 2 plus base times H sub 2. So, our L sub 1 is 12.2 centimeter plus our L sub 2 is 4.7 centimeter, and also our base is plus 7.9 centimeter times our height H sub 2 is equal to 20. So 12.2 plus 4.7 plus 7.9 is equal to 24.8. And we multiply it by 20 since our S sub 2 is 20 centimeter. So 24.8 times 20 is equal to 496 centimeter squared. Why is it that now that we have our lateral area, we can now move on or solve for our surface area? In finding the surface area, we should first solve for our base, the second area of our base. The formula in finding the base is 1/2 times base times height. So, our base is 7.9 centimeter, as you can see in our triangular illustration here. And our height is probably the 2.0 centimeter. So 7.9 times 2 is equal to 14.8 centimeters squared. Since it's 1/2, let us divide it by 2, which is equivalent to 7.9 centimeters squared. Now, we should solve for the surface area of the overall surface area for our main goal for today. In finding the surface area, the formula is equal to S is equal to L plus 2B. Length times length plus 2 base. Our length, our lateral area here is, now since we already solved for the lateral area, which is 496 centimeters squared, and our base is 7.9 times 2 is equal to 14.8. Then 14.8 plus 496 centimeters squared is equivalent to 511.8 centimeters squared. That's all.